Hi boys and girls, Mike here, One Go Short Play. Today we are playing 3D Battles of World Runner on the NES. My very first NES game. Exciting. As I mentioned on the last of my Mega Drive games, which was the end of C, Cyborg Justice, I never had a NES. I've been playing on one at the school I worked at, very, very briefly, while setting it up for the kids. And it looks like some good games, right? So I'm really looking forward to this. I've been a bit quiet today because that's a sleeping bebber. He's been playing all morning. Basically, the situation is his mummy is painting today. We've got a show coming up. Those of you who are in or around Leeds in 2 weeks' time, 3 weeks' time, no, 2 weeks' time, I think, will know that there's a retro gaming show. Oh, I don't know what that button did. 3D by the looks of it, something like that. Let's play this. We're called Sprites Delight and we do pixel art stuff. This is cool. I thought it was like Space Harrier when I first looked at it. I've got my controls mixed up though in the config, but I can live with that. Oh, this is excellent already. Oh, I'm just going to pause it and change the controls. Be right back. Okay, we are back. Just checking. That's better. I had left configured to up. Hey, it's a new emulator. I'm just learning. Oh, you can run faster. That's how you get over the big hole. This, all right, this is already excellent. Whoa, that's a massive hole. Oh, I love it. I do actually love it. Ooh, I see. This is really good. 3D Battles of World Runner. Really stupid name, but I wasn't expecting such a good game. See, I thought I'd play NES because never had one. Of course, wanted one as a kid, but didn't really get a choice in that latter because you don't when you're a kid. And it's one of those consoles that everyone tells you is better than the ones you had. I didn't believe it, but so far I'm starting to. This is excellent. Actually, excellent. Love this game. What a great idea. It's like an endless run. I'm sure it's not endless. I'm sure that's. I hate endless runners, but I've got a feeling this is structured with levels and whatnot. I'm really impressed. In fact, I want to copy this from my NES. First game I played, and I'm already blown away. What's that about? I was the Sega fanboy in school. Well, I think most of us were, to be honest, because we didn't really have that argument about Sega and Nintendo, because everyone, I don't know what happened there, everyone had Segas. It was just how it was. I'm sure all the games aren't going to be this good. Is this a really old NES game or a really late NES game? Oh, we've introduced you to the concept of pickups. Pick up as many as you can and put yourself at risk. No! I'm an idiot. Oh, that's good. Oh, that's a fun game. Yeah, so basically, Joe's upstairs having a paint because we need to get as many new pieces of art done for this show in 2 weeks as we can. We did collect Jubilee in Leeds a few months back and we didn't do very well. I think because we were selling paintings at painting prices and people didn't want to spend that sort of money. So we're hoping to do more with prints, cards and stuff like that this time. And we're just trying to find our feet and figure out what works for us and if it works for us. People keep telling us that this pixel art painting thing is going to really take off. And so far no dice. But we want to give it a good chance. So Jo's upstairs currently using every minute that she gets to, I really like this game, to paint. And it's Daddy's, just missed the button. It's Daddy's weekend with the baby. We've been to Toddler Sense. Those of you who have toddlers will know what that is. It's basically like a big sensory class with loads of soft play, songs and interaction with other kids. And, you know, parents do, of course, socialise a little bit. So that's what we did this morning. Then we had a snack and we went, did boring things like go in the bank and, you lose life if you hit. Of course you would. Go in the bank and picking up lunch and stuff like that. Came back and had a big hardcore play. And now he's knackered and he's out for the count. And I am currently stuck to the armchair because he's fallen asleep on me, of course. Not that I mind one bit. It's one of my favourite things in the world, and I know this is very limited, this experience. You know, in another year or two, it won't be, maybe, well, maybe you will be doing this, but it won't be the same. I mean, I'll get older and older, and I won't get to these little sleepy cuddles with them. So, I'm enjoying it while I can. I hope you don't mind that I brought a child to the to our gaming session. it's just how the cards fell in this particular situation. I'm going to play a few games with the babble on me. I'm sure it'll be no trouble. And when he is, I'll have to stop playing and play with him. This is awesome. I'd say it's quite samey, but they changed the colour scheme really well. I wouldn't expect the game to change much more than this, except for it to become more complex, of course, like it is becoming. Oh, it's good. But it's got this really good pace to it. It's really fun to play. It's really Moorish. I love the little animations, the forward animation, left and right animations are just right. Wait, was it four frame animations going on there? But they are spot on. You really get it across. I love the massive jumps you can do. Love the whole speed thing. That's a really nice touch. Although I just like going fast. It's a real Twitch game as well when you get these little minefields and monsters. Ooh, he twisted round on me there. Oh, it's good. Alright, I really, really enjoyed that first NES game. I'm going to check out how much that is on eBay. I bet it costs a fortune. It's probably really rare. Really love that. That was great. Let's see what else NES has got to offer. That was 3D Battles with World Runner. I'm sure it translates a little bit badly, the name there. It doesn't quite have a ring to it, does it? For the NES. Great game. Thanks for watching.